Summer is a great time to play outside. It's fun to go barefoot on the beach and by the pool, but I always make sure to wear shoes when I'm playing outside in the yard. Shoes are the best way to protect your feet from splinters. A splinter is a tiny, sharp piece of something that gets stuck in your skin. When you think of splinters, you might usually think of ones made of wood. But splinters can also be tiny pieces of glass, metal, or plastic. Splinters can get stuck in your skin when they break off of something, like a piece of wood from playground equipment. Sometimes they don't go in the skin very far, and they fall right out without you even noticing them. But other times, they go deeper, get stuck, and stay stuck until someone pulls them out. Usually, these kinds of splinters will hurt a little bit when they go into your skin. And if they go into your skin deep enough, you might even bleed. But a lot of times, a splinter can get stuck in your skin without you even noticing it. You don't even realize you have one until you do something that accidentally pushes the splinter deeper into your body. Then, ouch! If you don't notice a splinter right away, the skin around the splinter can get a little puffy and red and sore. These are all signs that your body has noticed the splinter, and it's getting ready to heal your skin. These signs also mean your body is doing its best to keep the splinter from going deeper into the skin. But your body can't always heal from a splinter properly on its own. That's why if you notice that you get a splinter, it's important to tell a grown-up so that they can help you take it out. Splinters, especially the ones made of wood or another piece of plant, like a cactus thorn or a prickle from a rose bush, can be covered with germs. When germs get inside of your body, they can start to multiply and make more germs. That's what's called an infection. So removing the splinter and the germs that might be on it is important. There's actually not a lot that goes into removing a splinter. Basically, your job is to hold still while someone uses a tool called tweezers to grab onto the splinter and pull it out. Before the person helping you gets started, you should wash the area around the splinter with warm water and soap. That will help get rid of any germs on your skin, which can help make sure that you don't get an infection. Soaking the area around the splinter with warm water will also help to soften your skin, which can make the splinter easier to remove. If the splinter is completely under your skin, meaning it's not sticking out anymore, the person removing the splinter might need to gently push the splinter until a little piece is sticking out. Then, they can use the tweezers to grab onto the splinter and gently pull. And with a little luck, the splinter will come right out. Afterward, it's a good idea to wash the area again with warm water and soap, and then cover it with a bandage. A few days later, you should be as good as new. Now, there are a few things you can do to keep from getting splinters. One thing is to be careful when you're playing outside around plants that might have thorns or prickles. You can also try to not rub your hands over pieces of wood that are rough or worn out. And of course, one of the best things you can do to keep your feet from getting splinters is to wear shoes. Now, I'm gonna put on my shoes and head outside to play. Thanks for joining us on SciShow Kids. If you'd like to continue learning and having fun with Squeaks and me, make sure to hit the subscribe button and join us every week here at the Fort.